Hello everyone, I hope you guys are doing well. So this is the part 5th of collection view series, in which we are going to learn how we can add a cell in a collection view dynamically. So let's look into the demo. So this is the demo. So this is the part which we have already learned how we can add buttons in collection view. So I have take one button outside from the collection view, and as I click on this button, an image picker is open, and we can pick an image from our album or the photo library, and as we click on any image, that image added in a new cell. So just try one more time. So we can add any image just simply like this, and we can perform the functionalities which we previously implemented on the same cells. Just like we able to delete the cell, we can able to show the cell, we can perform these functionalities with respect to the new cells which we get like this. Now we are able to delete any cell. So basically we add a image in a cell. We can add anything else according to our requirement. So this is my series, so I just add a image. So let's look into the code which we previously left. So this, let's run this program first and look where we are. So this is the point where we are. We have implemented this thing. So first we have to add one button over here. So let's change some layout. Just delete the top spacing constraint of collection view, and let's add one button. Let's add one button. Give the constraints whatever you want to give. I'm just giving 8, 16, and I'm just fixing the height. The height should be 30 and the width should be 60. You can use anything. And the title should be add. The text color should be white. And the background color should be maroon, so it will match our theme. Now give one constraints to this collection view, that is top, because there is a red mark and it shows that there is something missing. So add this constraint and it will become this yellow, and this is a warning. We can ignore this, but we don't have to ignore anything in this development series, so we have to remove this. So we will remove in the other session. Now we have to create an outlet action of this button, which was created in the view controller. So let's create an action. This button is related to the view controller, so we will add the action in the view controller, not in the extension. So this is an action. Now on the click of this button, we have to open an image picker. So for image picker, I've already created another video of image picker, in which video I've mentioned that how we can pick an image and even how we can edit that image, the size, the specific area in the image, how to select a specific area in that image. So please go through that video. So as I'm setting up the image picker, till now let's talk about some programming language. So people are thinking that programming language is difficult, but for me programming language is easy, because as we know that programming language, we have to follow some procedure, some step by step process to achieve some functionality, and of course we have to put some business logics to achieve this functionality. So it's all dependent on practice. More you practice, more you get. So the image picker setup is done. Now we have to add the picked image in an array of images. But right now we are having this array of strings, and we are converting this array of string into array of images when we are getting the images. But so we have to change this array of strings to the array of images. So I've already written this conversion of this array of string to array of images. So I'm just simply copying this thing and pasting over here. One more thing, that we are only adding an image and we are not able to access the name of the image which we picked from library. So right now we can't do that thing. So it's showing some errors. So obviously it's a kind of a UI image and it's a kind of a strings. So we have to simply pass the, so for here we have to pass the image. So we have to change the lines like img.arr and in that index part.row. And right now we are not getting any label or any text or the name of the image. So simply pass blank over here. And I guess, yeah, one more thing, that we have to change the name. We are not getting anything over here name. So we simply do this thing. So now I think all I have done, the only thing which is left, that we have to add this image, the picked image. This is a picked image which we have get from image picker. Now we have to add this image in an this image array. So for that we have to simply write img.append, and in the new element we have to pass the image. So simply we have to pass an image. And after passing an image, we have to reload the collection view. So simply collection view dot reload data. Now let's run the program and look that we achieved this thing or not. So till now all the things are working fine. Now let's add the image. Now it's an editing tool. You get this thing in my image controller video, so you can learn over there. So I'm not edit anything right now. I'm just selecting an original image. So I'm just clicking on choose, and as I click on choose, this thing is added in the cell. Just add one more thing. So then choose, and this cell is also again added. Now let's edit some image. Let's edit this image, and using editing, press Alt key and zoom the image and select the portion which you want to add in an image. So I just only want to add this plant. So I'm just choosing this plant only, and as I choose this plant, the whole image is selected. The whole image is selected because editing is not working. We just allowed the editing here, that image picker dot allow editing is true, but we are passing the original image, we are not passing the edited image. So for that we have to change this key, that edited image. Now we can run and check that now we are able to get the edited image or not. This is also the part of collection view series, so you can better understand that thing in that part. So let's take an image again. And let's edit that image by using Alt key and select this plant or whatever area you want to select. Now we are able to select the specific area in an image. Let's select one more time the whole image. Now we are able to get the whole image. Now able to select some specific region over from an image. So we are able to get a specific region in an image. So I hope you guys learned various things in my tutorial series. And if you really learn, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, and please comment how the tutorial was and what was the improvement area in the tutorial. And if you want any other thing related to the collection view, you can mention in the comment box, and as soon as I get time, I'll definitely create a video on that. And I hope you guys like my videos. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And my next video was on a scroller, an image scroller which we can achieve by using collection view. So thank you so much.